to be back.
Yeah, amazing. Perfect sweater weather, and you have a sweater with your face on it.
Typical actor, I have my face on my jumper. This is a charity t-shirt, so I feel like it's fine, right? I just have me on me. It raised money for Smile Train, which is the cleft palate charity that helps repair kids' cleft palates in developing countries. So they're an awesome charity, so I'm very proud to support them.
That's really cool.
Thank you.
So you've done a lot of cons like these since starting Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. What's your favorite thing about a weekend like this?
Oh, it's awesome. I mean, we don't have to do these. We choose to do them if we enjoy them. I feel like social media can be great, but you don't get the same. You don't get the same interactions. It's just not as good. So I love coming to these things and just meeting people and hearing what people think. And some people have great things to say. Other people have concerns, which I take on board. And it's just such a cool interaction. And I feel so lucky that I get to come and meet people and hear people's stories. And it's such an awesome part of. Getting to play Simmons that I never imagined as I was fighting hard for the role. I never imagined this moment, and I feel very, very lucky. So thank you.
Do you have any fan moments in particular that have stood out to you?
Honestly, I grew up with very strong female role models. My mom is a doctor, my grandma was a doctor, my aunts are doctors, and they're very, I've just been surrounded by strong, intelligent women that, and both my grandmothers were just, you know, traveled around, worked in the army, like, didn't see obstacles, I guess, or at least that's how I perceived them. And just the amount of young women I have coming up to me saying thank you for portraying a strong female character, it really hit home for me because I guess I just took that for granted that I had such strong female role models in my life, and so to be one for other people is, it's just such an honor. So I think that's the thing that struck me the most, I guess, is to be positive in that way. It's amazing. I don't write my poems, I just say them. So I'm glad that they have an impact.
I'm playing a scientist too, which is pretty unusual for like an awesome woman.
Right, and that's again, I didn't think of that because all the women in my family are scientists, so I'm the man actually. The next best thing for them, I at least play one on TV.
You almost realize.
Yeah, almost.
We're going to take audience questions starting in just a few minutes, so there's mics in the aisles if you want to go ahead and line up. But first, I wanted to ask you, season 4, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. premiered this week. Very exciting. Are you guys watching? Were you surprised when you saw in the script that we were going to be jumping forward 6 months?
You know, it's something we've done at the end of each season. We do have a time jump, and it just allows the writers to kind of start clean a little bit and kind of quietly wrap up some storylines. And it allows for a brand new theme and tone each season. And I think this season in particular, we've definitely changed. We're at 10 o'clock in the US now, which makes a big difference as to what they can write about, which makes me a bit nervous because everyone says it's going to get sexier. I feel like Simmons might have one less, I just don't know. But it's cooler and it means we can explore new themes without it being such a kind of a strange transition. So it just allows more freedom, basically.
Simmons is in the new director's like inner circle now. What do you think it is that's made her have this reaction to the sort of Inhuman developments?
I think she's come to terms with Inhumans now. I think she struggled with it at first, to be sure, and I think, once she saw the human element in the Inhumans, that's when things started to change for her. And Sky, I mean, anyone that hasn't seen the second season, I'm sorry, but Sky is an Inhuman, you guys. So when she figured that out, she loves Sky, who now is Daisy, who she loves still. Obviously, that was a turning point for her, but she's in the director's inner circle. She's been promoted, and Fitz hasn't. So sorry, Fitz. But she's doing it for the team, and that was kind of revealed in the first episode that she, even though she's kind of bossing people around, and it feels like maybe she's a bit power hungry, that actually her reason for doing it is so that she can kind of have the inside track to protect her teammates.
Nice. that leads to my next question. Fitzsimmons had a very exciting last season. I was pretty stoked about it.
Possibility of that?
Fitz and Matt?
Yeah.
God,
infiltrate Hydra and sort of getting stuck on a planet, and now she's in the drug executive circle. So what is something you want to see her do that is happy, I guess?
Great question. God, I forgot that she'd done so much. I would like to see her and Fitz just be happy, and I've been pushing them to be together and just be chill. So, I mean, some of my friends get against them right now and them just being together, but I feel like she's just come so far with her confidence in terms of her ability to be independent. So I'm happy that she's stepping up for the team, and I feel like she's taken a leadership role. And she's done that on her own initiative. You know, she didn't say to everybody, oh, this is why I'm doing it. She just went for the closure about it. So I'd like to see that. And then she has some really fun scenes coming up. But I think, yeah, she's in a happy place right now. We'll see. The team is all kind of split up right now, so there's a lot that can happen. But I think that my main thing is I just want her friends to be happy.
I really like, too, when she starts that initiative and get that like combat training when she went to May, and I think that was
a character evolution
too.
Yeah, thank you. I mean, you'll note that I haven't had any of that since. It was a shooting scene, and I feel like, right, Elizabeth, you have to keep your eyes open when you pull the trigger. I was like, I know, but I know it's gonna bite every time. And I feel like my eyes were shot. I mean, I don't know if you've ever tried it, it's like someone flicking in front of your face, and you have to keep your eyes open. I mean, everybody else seems to be able to manage.
I was wondering, do you think there's going to be any like big reveal in this season?
Yes, tell us.
Yes, there will. Know that when you see someone chewing, but what's going through their mind. So just stuff like that. Honestly, I mean, I've said it before, but the people that are the biggest pranksters on set are the heads of the department. So like the makeup department, I had to see one to hit Ian with a fire extinguisher, and I was so worried that it was gonna hurt. It was just fake fire extinguisher. But for whatever reason, I was just worried.
Bye.
Would you want to?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
sure. She would kick some butt in the Infinity War.
I feel like at least try, yeah. Yeah. She'd probably be a bit sadistic about it as well, like create some potions.
Hi, Elizabeth.
Hi.
I just want to thank you again for being so energetic and kind all the time. It's been long days and everything, so thank you for coming again. And
thank you. You guys have a much harder than I just sit at a desk and basically get people coming up to me that are really nice. I feel like you guys have to walk around and line up and all that stuff, so I appreciate you guys a lot. Thank you.
Thank you. So my question is, growing up, did you ever have a favorite Marvel character? Because now that you are in this massive universe, how does it feel just to know, oh, right, I'm in this gigantic universe filled with characters I love?
It's crazy, honestly. I can't really explain it, and I forget, and then someone will give me a comic to sign, which is crazy that someone will give me anything to sign anyway, and then when it has your face on it, it's crazy, mad, just bizarre. My Avengers was the first movie that I went to with the midnight showing and all of that stuff. Actually, I did go to Iron Man 2, but I guess Avengers was the first one where with Black Widow and just it was just so. Firstly, I wanted to have her a movie. Amazing novels about Black Widow, and like her past is just so rich, and I feel like there's so many stories to tell there. So yeah, that was the kind of the first character I guess that I was like, this is really cool, and she holds her own. And it's just an honor to be a part of it, and I think the Marvel fans are unlike any other fans in the world, and they teach us everything we need to know. Just to be a part of it is awesome, and we've always felt like, I think there was a lot of pressure on us at the start, being the first live action Marvel TV show, but I've never felt intimidated by it, and it's because of the fan base. We were just kind of held very safely somehow. Yeah, people had stuff to say about when we first started out and still do, but it was always constructive criticism, which is just so rare in this industry.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Have you been given a lot of comics to read since you started on this?
Yeah, so on our first meeting, Jeff Lowe, who's the head of Marvel Television, who's a wonderful comic book writer himself, just popped a bunch of comics in front of each of us, and yeah, it was really cool homework.
Yeah, that's the best part.
Right.
Yeah. Can't complain about that.
And they were free. We just walked right out of it. So
even better.
Roles that I guess I've been introduced to that are producers or writers, everyone involved in it.
throwing one here for you. I'd like to challenge you to a dance off.
Ooh.
Okay. Yeah, I'll get down for it.
Yeah. I don't know if you have any tunes though.
I don't know either. We can just make our own music too.
There's no.
Are you a good dancer? No, I'm not.
With his recovery, and you play Simmons, but in Fitz's subconscious, just wondering what it's like to approach those scenes. Like, are you still just playing Simmons, or do you have to come at it in a different way?
Yeah, that's such a great question, because I struggled with that, to play the imaginary Simmons, because basically, I played her as if I was Fitz, what Fitz would want. So I didn't have the same, all my objectives and intentions with my lines were to do with Fitz and Simmons, which was kind of crazy to get my head around. And then that outfit that she was in, just a shout out to Anne Foley, who's our costume designer, she was in the outfit from 106 where she jumped out of the plane and Fitz tried to save her. So because in his mind that was the moment everything changed with their relationship. That's when he realized he loved her. So that was the significant moment. So I just tried to sort of channel what he wanted, because he'd created her in that moment, sort of thing. And then the infiltrating Hydra thing was just so fun, because it was the first time she got to lie convincingly. Usually she was so rubbish, but I am so rubbish at lying too. So I was just proud of us both for being able to do that. And then I got to work with Adrienne Blinky, and I was like the first one of our team to be able to work with her.
Thank you.
love to work with Kate Blanchett. I think she is the epitome of a fine actress. So I think she would be my number one. Silly things like that. Did you guys have a boy band?
No.
Anyway, so then I had to
truck that sold churros, so I got my churro in the end.
Thank you for reliving that.
Yeah, that was painful.
I don't think you can let no Spider-Man. I'm sure. Well, you were doing a sign-in right after this panel.
Yes, super quick, and then I've got to run to the airport. So I just want to say thank you so much. You guys just, you changed our lives, really. It's just amazing to get this interaction. And it's thanks to you that we're still at the moment. We love what we're doing.